Black student forced to act out the murder of George Floyd. Let me remind you of the scene he was forced to act out. Let's put up the picture of that infamous moment that shook the nation around the entire globe. So a kid was forced to act this out. Let's go to the middle school. Put up a picture of the middle school. On January 18th, at West Sylvan Middle School in Oregon, a group of bullies imitated the George Floyd murder using a black classmate. The incident started when the unnamed black eighth grader was allowed to get water from the hallway water fountain. As the student went to use the fountain, two other students confronted him. Let's go to Raheem, put his picture up. Raheem Alexander, the student's father, described what happened to his son next. Here's a quote. "They pushed him up against the wall," he says. "They bound his hands behind his back using a hall pass lanyard and told him they were doing a George Floyd on him," Alexander told KATU News. "They put him face down on the ground with his hands behind his back. They proceeded to put a knee in his back. One of the students said to him that now they are turning off the body camera and they're going to wait 20 seconds, Alexander said. Once again, visual reminder of what they made this black child act out. West Sylvan principal, Dr. Jill Hunt, released the following statement. She said, and I quote, "I am deeply saddened to share that West Sylvan experienced a horrific hate-based incident last week. Because this is an ongoing investigation involving students, we are limited in what we are able to communicate to families." The letter went on to say, "The students involved received appropriate disciplinary action. Counselors will work with students on anti-racist lessons." You know, and it's interesting because naturally you do have to work with students. You have to work with faculty, administrators. But the origin of this comes from the family, the origin of it. It is then enhanced by the culture. Racism is enhanced in culture. And when it is not properly checked in places of public social interaction, like a school, it permeates in a way that ends up on this show. There's more. Oregon Live confirmed the students who attacked the black eighth grader, they have all been expelled. Response from the district in a statement. Portland Public Schools said the district stands firmly against any hateful acts in our schools or community. The students' parents felt the district waiting to respond publicly was not satisfactory. They said the school district declined to issue a district-wide statement citing the ongoing investigation and the Family Educational Rights and Privacy Act. Let me be very clear. I'm well aware of that act. And if the superintendent or the principal decides to stand behind that act, let me give them the 411 since they have not bothered to read it. It stops you as an educator or administrator from providing specific details as it relates to minors, such as name and address or information that is readily connected to a particular child involved in an incident. A public statement is permissible as long as the public statement allows for the rule to be adhered to. So to the parents, your instinct was correct. It's a bunch of BS that they cannot release a district-wide statement. All right, Jeff, thoughts?
You know, for a number of the ills of this country, like let's say mass shootings and violent crime, I always hear it starts at home. But boy, in these situations like this story right here, I will never hear someone say it starts at home. You know, for racism and a culture of hate that you outlined earlier. And I'm sure, Dr. Richey, your audience knows about the school to prison pipeline, but for some reason, I've never put it in my mind to come up with like a school to police academy pipeline, because the students who did that, they are right on their way to get into a police academy. Like, they're only a few years away. You gotta be 18 or something like that. They're right there. Yeah. I mean, look, you know, with a uniform and an unchecked sense of authority, you know, people can get carried away. And that's what we see all the time. So let's look into this.
You made a great point. And I would say this to echo that point. If those kids were acting out, I don't know, a local gang member, right? They were acting out, mimicking the life of a gangster, everyone would be up in arms. They are mimicking the life of a gangster. It just so happens that the gangster was being paid by taxpayers and had on police blue rather than Crip blue, but it was still acting out of gang culture. When will all individuals have a problem with this? All right, we will provide updates as they come.